my father is on the board of the American Cancer Society, although he said the voting was unanimous for Dawn.
Well, that is quite an honor. And as much as we appreciate the invitation, we're heading back to Pittsburgh the minute I leave your office smiling.
You're really gonna rush off? I think Ken got you tickets to the new Edward Albee play.
Oh, we saw it on Tuesday.
You did?
Yeah, we came in a couple days early. Alice loves the city. Did I not mention that?
No reason to, I guess.
Raymond, would you order me a Sanka? I'm gonna freshen up.
And some dessert. Come on, why not?
You know, I've always wanted to eat here. I thought it was just for Time Life employees.
You know, I really enjoy spending time with you.
I feel the same way, Alice.
I'm only saying this because Raymond's putting on such a good show. He didn't want to go to dinner. He just wanted to do it in your office. He's a good man, I swear.
Of course he is.
I was really prepared to not like you, but you're so good for that man, and you're so lively.
Thank you,
I'm just Alice. Saying, I hope we can continue to be friends.
Now, see, the truth and packaging bill they wanted to pass would hit everybody hard. But now there's no teeth, so nothing should change.
We're getting fired.
Sorry, but we ended up getting more dessert than we bargained for. Who's up for a nightcap?
That's okay. I think we're gonna turn in.
Do me the favor, Raymond. You don't know this, but you rescued me from a house full of in-laws and children. Can we get a bottle of Sauternes and 6 glasses?
I don't know. We have the early meeting tomorrow and the flight back.
You know, Don jokes about having a house full of people, but he loves it. Don? Don, tell them about last night.
Oh, well, we had 3 generations under one roof. Megan, her mother, and my 12-year-old, Sally.
Sally won't eat anything, as you might imagine.
Except beans, of course.
It's true.
They do like them. Never had any worries about that.
You should have seen it. Megan bringing the pot in, spooning them out on the plate. Her mother was smiling.
A darling saint.
Actually, I didn't know if I'd done something wrong because Don was staring at us. But apparently I'd given him this idea.
She did.
Don, you sure you want to talk about this now?
Let him talk.
Obviously, there's more to it. But I think it would be a series of one-shot little movies. One mother starting in the prehistoric caves, serving beans to a shaggy little boy by the fire. Then a Greek woman in a toga with a little shepherd boy. Then Marie Antoinette to a little prince. Calamity Jane, a pioneer boy, all the way through the gay 90s to today, in a kitchen like yours.
Would it all be the same mother and child?
We hadn't thought of that, but that might work.
Tell them the rest of it.
Well, it goes past present day to the future, to a little lunar kitchen with the Earth off in the window. You know, futuristic clothing, interesting bowls. And the kid has just taken off his space helmet as he takes a warm bite.
Oh, that's clever.
That was Megan's idea.
When Don told me, I thought, we're all so busy and we rush around and it will probably always be like that, but a mother and child and dinner, that'll never change.
Heinz beans. Some things never change.
Can I get some more coffee?
Shh.
I don't know what to say. Let me think about it. See the pictures.
Raymond, really? It's beautiful. And it's exactly... I don't know. Can I get the cream, please?
Well, we were dancing around a few other things, too.
No, we weren't. This is what you're gonna see tomorrow. It's a once-in-a-lifetime idea.
Raymond, you could save yourself a trip to the office tomorrow. Or we can get in the elevator, go down 11 floors, and show you the work right now.
It's the future. That's all I ever wanted.
Should we change that sauterne to champagne?
Sure. Why the hell not?